we are on now for the determinant part. In the contents, we wrote determinant of order 1 by 1, determinant of order 2 by 2, determinant of order 3 by 3. Now, we are just starting with the determinant of order 1 by 1. Now, what is determinant of the order 1 by 1? Now, suppose we are having, let A be a square matrix of order 1 by 1. Okay. Let A is equal to A. Okay. So, what is the determinant? Then, determinant A or we can write anything. This is just a representing. It can be represented by this one. It can be represented by this one. It can be represented by this also. Okay. So, determinant of A is equal to A. The quantity A, the element A, that is a number, that is a complex number, that is itself a determinant of order 1 by 1. Okay. So, now suppose we are having A is equal to 5. Okay. So, now this is a matrix for order 1 by 1. If we are writing like this, now it is, then it will be determinant of A is equal to 5. Okay. Determinant of, suppose we are having 5 iota. Okay. So, determinant of A will be 5 iota itself. So, representing a determinant of order 1 by 1, suppose A is equal to only one single element, that is A, then determinant of that particular matrix, determinant of capital A is equal to small a, the quantity of that A, that is for 1 by 1. Now, let's move for determinant of order 2 by 2. Determinant of order 2 by 2. So, now, we are having again a square matrix. Now, we are having square matrix capital A. Capital A is equal to A11, A12, A21, A22. Okay. Now, the determinant for the square matrix is, it will be, what it is? It is is equal to A11, A22 minus A21, A12. Okay. This is the determinant. Now, what we have done? What we have done? We have gone like this one. From top to this one and from this side to this side. You have to go like this. Now, from where it comes? From where this comes? I gave you an example in the introduction that we can represent a equation in the form of matrix is equal to C1 and C2. Okay. Now, we have gone it that determinant means the value. Okay. Value can be a numeric, it can be in the real form, it can be a complex form. Then, how to find the uniqueness of this part? Uniqueness of this part was A1 B2 minus A2 B1. This was the uniqueness. And what we wrote it? We wrote it A1 B2 minus A2 B1 is not equal to 0. So, this one and this one is the one and the same thing. Okay. So, for order 2, determinant of order 2 can be calculated by multiplying this one and this one, elements of the principal diagonal minus elements of the sub-principal diagonal. Okay. Other than the principal diagonal. So, that is the determinant. And now, what exactly this is called? This is called the determinant and value after calculating, whatever value we are getting, after calculating, the value is called value of determinant, is called value of determinant. Now, value of determinant exactly is what? Same, it is called determinant. Okay. So, these were the two things for order 1 by 1 and order 2 by 2. Now, after doing this part, we are going with some very nice examples for the determinants.